Greetings, everyone. Welcome to our coverage of the NBA on 2K Sports. And tonight, we'll see the Toronto Raptors as they go up against the Philadelphia 76ers at Wells Fargo Center. This is Brian Anderson, joined courtside by Grant Hill and Clark Kellogg. Our reporter tonight, Allie LaForce. Allie, take it away.
Kyle Lowry last season broke the Raptors' all-time record for assists. It was also his sixth straight All-Star selection. But he said, quote, "I am never complacent. How I got here was through hard work, so why stop now?" Guys, the lead guard spot is a nightly challenge. He knows he's got to be on point.
Yes, he does. Thanks, Allie. Good stuff there. And now a chance to see what's coming up for the Philadelphia 76ers. On Thursday, they'll begin a road trip starting in Orlando, going up against the Magic. And then on Saturday, they'll go up against Gordon Hayward and the Charlotte Hornets. So the Raptors starting five. At the forward spots, it's Ananobi and Siakam. Lowry and Van Vliet man the backcourt, and it's Baines in at the center. And for Philadelphia, Harris and Embiid make up the front court. Ben Simmons is out there with Seth Curry, and it's Green in at the three. And what are the things that teams can afford to tinker with at this stage of the season, Clark, compared to later in the year?
I think rotations are still things you can work on, and sometimes out of necessity, whether it's injury or a player not playing well, it sometimes just kind of comes up. And coaches find something that they weren't looking for that can be beneficial.
Now here's Van Vliet. Up top, Lowry. Watch the screen. Over Simmons. Lowry, good.
The first of many tonight. Both teams have legit offensive talent.
Boy, I tell you what, that's going to be like a pinball machine, the way that scoreboard's going to light up.
Embiid against Baines. Fader on the way. And that one off the back of the rim and in.
The mid-range J from Embiid. Getting better and better.
Van Vliet, the pass to Siakam. The rebound by Embiid. Outside Simmons. Pass to Embiid. Outside Green. Here's Harris. Outside Curry. This one for three. That shot off. Now Toronto takes it the other way. A tough loss coming against San Antonio in their last game. Basket counts.
Just taking it right to the rim, and no one was there to greet him.
Well, this early, they should be showing a lot more energy on defense. It's not there.
Now here's Simmons. He had a 15-point outing in their last game against the Cavs in Cleveland.
And another key for them was his rebounding. Just a great effort.
Embiid misses. The Raptors have gone 2 of 3 to get this one going. Outside Ananobi. Back to Lowry. Van Vliet outside. Fires from deep. And it's Harris with the rebound.
And this is exactly who you want taking that shot. He just missed it.
Simmons, the pass to Green. Harris against Van Vliet. Pass to Embiid. Shot clock at 5. That puts him in the lead.
Hey, there is no denying, B.A., that Joel Embiid is the embodiment of the 76ers. As a matter of fact, the man's name is the process, for crying out loud. I mean, he's all in on this team, and the city is all in with him. They love his personality, and his talent is unquestioned.
Now here's Lowry.
Now, the defense was far from awful. However, he still got to make these shots, in my opinion.
They get the rebound. The kick out. Curry. And the 76ers another three.
Hey, that's good vision from Harris. I mean, he draws so much attention himself, so he's become a capable passer.
Well, Clark, it's a bit of a love-hate relationship now with Embiid in Philadelphia.
Well, I love the young man's skill set and his personality. He's real and he's a tad raw at times, but hey, in Philly, he said he could be the hero or villain last year, and I think he just loves getting into it, engaging with folks. He can give it and receive it. But deep down, I think there's tremendous respect between Embiid and the city of brotherly love.
Now here's Siakam, coming off a 16-point game against San Antonio.
And he really dominated, working hard to control the glass.
Harris against Baines. And we're just over 3.5 minutes into this first quarter. Outside Simmons. Late clock, the Sixers need to put one up here. Embiid. And no good, trying to use the glass.
You know, he just has not been himself this period. Just too inconsistent, up and down at the offensive end.
Van Vliet against Embiid. Here's Baines. And Baines with the slam.
Not the tallest center in the league. He more than makes up for it with those crazy hops.
Pass to Harris. Down low. Here's Embiid. And the shot is good. Harris making the play. Embiid's got his second basket of the night.
This is where Embiid burns you the most. I mean, mainly because of his size and such a soft touch.
Baines with a screen. With some arc. Lowry, no good.
It's one thing to prevent the layup. It's another to do it without fouling. Just terrific defense.
You know, defensively, you just can't afford to give him that much room. They're fortunate that he missed that one.
Kicks it out to Siakam. From deep. Buries it. He's 2 for 4 in this game.
And just so accurate off the pass. I mean, I love whenever Siakam decides to go right up with it like that.
Pass to Harris. Here's Embiid. Checked by Baines. Buries it from three. Lowry with it. Coming off a 16-point game against San Antonio.
In total command of the offense, the passing was insane, especially when you consider how many points he put up.
Now here's Van Vliet. Lowry, no good. Outside, Green. That's good from Curry on the assist by Green. Curry's got 11 points.
You know, throughout this quarter, guys, they've had no answer for him defensively. And he's been absolutely relentless.
Lowry, good.
Incredible control there from Lowry. Superb at keeping his composure, even when things get physical.
Time called here. The 76ers decide to talk it over. Outplayed in their previous game on their schedule, losing to the Cavs.
It really just wasn't a fun game for them. Their offense looked stagnant, and they couldn't get anything going.
Yeah, they had no answer for them. They simply got outplayed and outworked.
And the 76ers going with a whole new group out there. Here's Scott. He had a 12-point outing in their last game against the Cavs in Cleveland. Siakam outside. Inside. Lowry, no good. For Philadelphia, they've got 6 of 14 in so far. To the paint. Oh, a rim-rattling two-handed jam!
With two hands on the rock, he powers it through.
Totally in control, protecting the ball the whole way.
And he should be. I mean, remove all doubt. Get it down hard and simple. Certainly not the kind of night he was looking for at the offensive end, and it's had a ripple effect on the team.
Knocked loose and stolen by Boucher. Here comes Toronto on the push. Powell's shot is off.
They sure are. I mean, they've done a terrific job carving out space under the basket and then pursuing the ball. You know, it's one thing to box out, but you've got to pursue the ball if you're going to get rebounds. And they look strong here in the early going.
It's tipped. Lowry outside. Played it in with a nice touch off the window. Lowry's got 6.
That's a nice display of patience inside from Lowry. Didn't rush his shot, takes his time, and really does a nice job sinking these high percentage looks.
Now here's Milton. Still getting warmed up offensively. No buckets yet in the game from him. Shot clock at 6. Powell with a steal. To the wing, right side. 3-pointer. Lowry, no good. Philadelphia has gone 3 of 6 shooting from beyond the arc. Here's Korkmaz. And it's Toronto with a rebound. And guys, this is the first they're seeing of the 76ers this year. Here's Thomas. Pass to Siakam. Ooh, and he took a hard foul on the shot. So he'll head to the line to shoot a pair.
And there's a lot to admire about how Pascal Siakam attacks defenders. I mean, he's so shifty outside, and he absorbs contact so well when he gets to the rim. He's stronger than you'd think from looking at his frame. Two shots. Last on the
first. And he knocks down the first one. Sneaky strength of Siakam. It's one of the reasons why he's such a tough matchup.
He really is a tough matchup. He will put bigger guys on skates out there on the perimeter. Of course, he can still play back to the basket on the block. There's no easy answer for how you match up with Siakam.
The Raptors making a switch here. Bembry's checked in, and it's tied up with that one. And the 76ers with possession. Outside Milton. Here he goes. Bembry grabs the miss.
Well, we talk about the value of great rim protection. That's a shot he typically makes.
High post Boucher. It's Siakam with the drive. Howard with some nice D. The 76ers shooting only 39% in the early going. Pass to Milton. Out to the right wing. Here's Maxey. There's the drive. Oh, and he got fouled on his way up. He'll head to the line to shoot two. They'll pin that one on Pascal Siakam.
Take a break. Take a break. Two shots.
That one's off. Thybul, he's checked in for the Sixers. He hits the second from the line. And 101 left in the first quarter here. Siakam outside. Chance there to take the lead, but a miss.
That's the shot you hope for, right at the rim. Just couldn't capitalize.
Here's Maxey. On the take. Six on the shot clock. And that one drops for him. And the 76ers lead by three.
Showing off with the floater game. Not a shot you can swat.
7 second difference between the shot clock and the game clock. Powell. And the layup is good off the glass.
You got to appreciate the consistency. Night in and night out, he brings it.
Now Milton. Looking for his first basket still in this one. Pass to Maxey. Let's go with a three. Knocks it down from distance.
I love it. Just thumbing his nose at the height disadvantage. He's able to get the space he needs and convert.
And you look at him, he's given up an awful lot of size in that matchup, so he needs to have the ability to create separation.
And so the first quarter is in the books. Sixers ahead, up four. And the second quarter is on its way when we return. And reminiscing about his championship year with Kawhi Leonard, Pascal Siakam shared this with us.
He was always a team. And I think we don't look at one player and say he's going to save us. You know, we got to save each other. We got to play for each other.
And that's how Siakam plays the game himself.
Yeah, versatile, very unselfish, and a franchise player in his own right.
And for those of you just tuning in, second quarter action is where we are. All right, guys, what's your take on the Sixers so far?
Well, it's simple. When you can dominate the boards at both ends, you can control the second chance touches.
And, you know, their rebounding advantage has been glaring, simply outworking them on the boards for that entire first quarter.
Harris and Embiid make up the front court. Seth Curry is out there with Ben Simmons. And it's Thybul in at the three. That's the group in the game for the 76ers. And Embiid, no good on that one. All right, Grant, if you could choose one big man to play alongside right now, who would it be?
Well, other than you, B.A., I'd have to go with Anthony Davis. I think he's a tremendous offensive player, his shooting ability, his length. He's also very unselfish, a tremendous defender as well, a rim protector, can guard multiple positions. I think he's just an unselfish guy who's really about team and trying to do all he can to help his ball club win. So definitely Anthony Davis. And you're up there too, B.A.
Just five to shoot. Three-pointer, Van Vliet.
The activity on defense by Seth Curry. Very good. Reaching, staying with his man, moving his feet. He's a good, solid position defender.
Back to Thybul. And here's Simmons. Well, he hasn't scored yet, but I'm sure that'll change. Here's Curry. And there's a whistle. He'll head to the line to shoot two. It goes on Fred Van Vliet. Typically, around half of Curry's shots are from three, but he's really a threat from anywhere on the floor, Grant.
Yeah, great point, B.A. He has a tremendous mid-range game, and we saw that from him back in college. He's really improved his shot off the dribble, too. And what you love is the confidence. This is a guy who believes everything he puts up is going in, and you know what? If I were him, I would, too.
And that one falls for Curry.
And just like his brother Steph, Seth is an impressive bucket getter. I mean, somebody whose role is to shoot and score the ball.
Green's checked in for Thybul. Lowry, he's checked in for Toronto. And so Curry nails both of them.
Making shots at the line. You need a good routine, and he certainly has one.
Boy, they'd love if anyone could get a bucket.
Yeah, their offense has been grinding to a halt.
And from the sideline, let's catch up with Allie.
The Sixers are showing belief in their star duo of Ben Simmons and Joel Embiid. But at the same time, it's been a revolving door for the surrounding pieces. J.J. Redick, Robert Covington, Jimmy Butler, they've all come and gone. Guys, for their star talent to translate in the playoffs, perhaps some continuity would help.
Agreed. Thanks, Allie. So it's Toronto now. The Sixers getting their last shot to go. Van Vliet misses.
And really a reflection of their superior effort level to this point. It seems to me they've gone after this win a little bit more.
And the foul called on Aaron Baines. That's his first foul.
Yeah, they've been pretty careless so far, racking up a number of fouls in very little time.
Second quarter of basketball. Just over a minute and a half played so far. Pass to Embiid. Back to Harris. Five on the clock. There's the triple. The shot no good. So the Raptors will take it the other way. Lowry outside. Van Vliet outside.
Yep, that's another miss for him. They're behind in this game largely because he shot so poorly.
The three from Curry. They get it again. And the refs are going to rule that unnecessary contact. That's a flagrant one foul.
Ooh, hard foul. Can't let him get away with that level of contact.
That's a simple call for the officials to make. Everyone knows the league is cracking down on that kind of intimidation tactic.
Take a break. Two shots.
first free throw is good.
And we know Joel Embiid knows that he's one of the best in the game. You love it when he challenges other stars and goes right at them on the floor. Embiid is a true superstar and super personality in the league.
He's perfect from the line this time.
That's a great job getting to the line here. You know, he didn't have a single attempt in that first quarter because I thought he was tentative. Much more aggressive here in the second.
Pass to Harris. Here's Korkmaz. The Sixers again can't hit. Grant, last season, Embiid declared himself the best player in the league. Not many echoed that statement.
Yeah, B.A., most fans and pundits will disagree with Embiid. It's hard to make a case for him. But that's the mentality Embiid has to have as a superstar. So who knows? In a few years, it might be true.
I'll tell you what, they've rebounded the ball tremendously well.
Yeah, you look across the board, it's actually sizing up, shaping up to be a great game. I mean, strong performances throughout, and they've really been strong on the glass.
Well, Grant, you were able to represent the United States on an international stage. Give me a few stories about that experience.
Brian, it was one of the highlights of my career in 1996 in Atlanta to play along with six members from the original Dream Team. Really, truly just one of the best experiences. I got a chance every day to practice with, to go against, to learn from Scottie Pippen when he was in his prime. I just finished my second year in the NBA, and it just truly was a remarkable, incredible experience. Gold medal, really, like I said, one of the highlights of my career.
Boy, he's a real bully inside. I mean, you forget sometimes that Simmons is 6'9", 6'10", with nice touch. It's a nice combination near the basket.
Now here's Van Vliet. 27 points his last game.
Slow reaction from the D, and it cost him three.
Now here's Simmons. Pass to Harris. Embiid inside. Baines is there. And the basket by Embiid.
Boy, what a quarter for him. I mean, he's found his rhythm, and he's really riding that wave right now.
Lowry with it. 6 points for him. High arcing shot, and it's blocked by Embiid.
You look at this combination of reach and timing, it makes Embiid a superb shot blocker.
Pass to Van Vliet. Baines, a screen on Simmons. And there's the foul. It's on Joel Embiid. That's his first foul. And Clark, when you look back at the environment of the bubble, how do you think you would have played as a player?
B.A., I have no idea. As a matter of fact, you know, I used to tell people that my playing days are in my rearview mirror. I can't even see my playing days anymore. That's how long ago it's been. But I think I would have adjusted just like any player would have. I mean, once you get between the lines, that's where your focus is. The atmosphere and environment is part of it, but between that 94 by 50 foot box, it's about competition and trying to outdo your opponent. So I think I would have adjusted fine.
Now here's Simmons. Pass to Harris. Here's Korkmaz. Now Embiid. Checked by Baines. Tipped. Now Ananobi. Here's the three. And it's Harris with the rebound. Harris has got his fourth rebound in this one.
And right now, they're plus eight in the rebounding category. That's helping them run away with this.
Yeah, double-digit advantage on the scoreboard. They've taken the initiative. They've played, I think, with more purpose so far.
Pascal Siakam, he's checked in for Toronto. Powell comes in for Ananobi. Outside Simmons. Pass to Scott. Six to shoot. Here's Korkmaz. Knocks down the triple. Korkmaz has got five now.
That's been typical of their performance today. They're sharing the ball and creating good shots.
Really a prime example of the difference in how these teams have operated offensively. Much more individual play at the other end.
Look how Lowry works his way inside. He's so sly, even up against that defense.
Now the 76ers with it. They're on an 18-7 run. Pass to Korkmaz. And there's the drive. It's good. And a beautiful setup from Simmons that time. Korkmaz has got 5 points in the quarter. They've been having major problems offensively.
Definitely in a bit of a dry spell.
Lowry, no good.
Boy, just cannot buy a bucket, guys. And tell you what, that's a painful quarter for him, and it's painful for me to watch, too.
Milton with it. Up top, Embiid. Pass to Scott. Clock at 6. And here's Simmons. He's in his comfort zone. 2 for 2 to start this one.
And they found a nice flow offensively here in the second period.
Yeah, and that field goal percentage zooming upwards is now above 50%, which is pretty strong.
Now a timeout called by Toronto.
You know, the moment everybody was waiting for with Ben Simmons happened last year. He made a few threes during games. It was a small sample size, no doubt about that, but it's what the fans wanted to see, and I'd like to continue to see him add that part to his game.
And the Raptors with some changes. Thomas comes in for Van Vliet, and it's Bembry in for Lowry. To the left wing. Back to Siakam. Pass to Powell. Here's Bembry. Now here's Siakam. Over Milton. Philadelphia grabs the miss. Simmons has got his 6th rebound on the night. All right, Clark, for Simmons, a step in the right direction.
Agreed. I mean, as fantastic as he is, and believe me, he is, ball handling, passing, rebounding, speed, all of that is 5-star level. But he's not a really good shooter, and that does lead
to... Oh, big time right there.
Nasty!
Wow. Siakam putting something extra on that one. Just a gifted player with style and substance.
Simmons up top. Here's Howard. Oh, he powers right through the defender for the dunk. Draws the foul, too. And he'll go to the line. Aaron Baines picks one up.
One shot.
And the free throw, no good.
I love it. In attack mode, drawing foul calls this quarter and getting to the free throw line.
My kind of hoops. Straight ahead, playing downhill and physical.
Powell, it's good.
And when you're trailing in a game, it can be tempting to try to go for the big play.
Yeah, trying to get it all back in a hurry. And you're right on that. But these threes they're taking have not helped. They're trying to catch fire. And they've yet to find the match.
Here's Thomas, guarded by Howard.
Would you say testing the limits of his range there?
You know, guys, I think he's got confidence to shoot it from anywhere, but he could have gotten a better one than that.
He almost brought the basket down on top of himself.
Oh, there's hang time, and then there's a time to hang.
Well, you got to make that moment last. Enjoy it for as long as you can.
Here's Siakam. It's hauled in by the Sixers.
Who's got Simmons?
Simmons, the pass to Howard. The kick out to Simmons. Outside Milton. Just 5 on the clock. And that one is stuffed right through.
And clearly not enough defensive presence there.
Boy, he just took advantage and a ferocious jam.
And, guys, that'll get his heart rate up a little bit, I can tell you that. Watch out. He can be a dangerous player when his motor is revved up that way.
Man, he made sure to get his money's worth on that foul.
He got him good there. I mean, that's why the shot was so far off.
First free throw is good. Van Vliet's checked in for Toronto. Siakam hits them both. 51 seconds left in the first half. Here's Maxey. Pass to Curry. And count it. Now 5 for 7.
Setting each other up beautifully. I love it. 8 of their last 10 points coming off assists.
You know, nothing makes a coach happier than selflessness on the basketball court.
The drive by Siakam. Basket's good. Siakam's got 6 in the quarter.
And just a straight baller move from Siakam. I mean, shrugging off the coverage and keeping his focus on that basket.
There's 21 seconds left in the second. And here's Curry for 3. Nails it. He's now 6 for 8 from the floor.
Well, he's cooking with grease. He's got things flaming up, looking for an opportunity every time down the floor when he's that hot.
Now Siakam. 2 on the clock. And some nice defense there to end the quarter.
Get that weak stuff out of here around Howard. Return to sender is what he stamped that one with.
Here's Thomas. Ooh, he released it in time, but it's off the mark. And through the first half, a pretty lopsided affair. The Sixers on top, opening up a huge gap. All right, Allie's ready to go. She's courtside. Hey, Allie.
Joel, the reserves have been awesome so far. What are you seeing from them?
The bench has helped us a lot. They've come in, they've scored the ball, they've got to stop, so we're going to need them to keep it going.
Helps to have backup. Good luck in the second half.
Appreciate it, Allie. And we'll be coming right back after this break, ready for the third quarter.
It's the 2K Sports Halftime Show.
Hello again, everyone. That was a combination of everybody and everyone. Everyone. Did you catch that?
I got it.
Yeah, Ernie Johnson, Kenny the Jet Smith, Shaquille O'Neal. How about that first half, fellas? We know that Joel Embiid is one of the best centers in the league, but Shaq, I ask you, as the resident big man expert, what does Embiid do better than everyone else right now?
Well, for a player his size, the amount of skill he has is very unfair. He's one of the most skilled bigs since Akeem the Dream Olajuwon, the last man to embarrass me.
Well, Embiid, you know, he's a top defender, and he's still deep on that defensive end, and you can't sleep on him, I tell you. But you know what? I used to be a big man. Initially, I was. I used to play a big man in like middle school. And then I became like a point forward, and then I became a small forward, then I became the point guard. I skipped right over the two guard position.
Somebody got the siren that they can
just let you know. Don't hate me because I played both.
In middle school.
And that wraps up the halftime show. Third quarter set to begin in just a few.
And with a big gap on the scoreboard, the second half begins with very different goals for these teams. One side trying to mount a comeback, one side trying to protect their lead. Seth Curry really making an impact here today.
Through the first two quarters, he's been on fire. Explosive offensive performance.
And you know what? I'll be interested to see just how much he's got left in the tank. That first half had to take a lot out of him.
And as we dive into the second half, we'll find out if the next two quarters are any different from the first two. So far, it's been a runaway. So for the Raptors right now, Lowry and Van Vliet man the backcourt. At the forward spots, it's Ananobi and Siakam, and it's Baines in at the 5. Here's Curry. No good. And Toronto will go the other way with it. To the inside. Oh, Oh, stolen by Harris. Right side, Simmons. Oh, a dunk and a foul. A powerhouse move. He's got a chance for one more at the line. That'll belong to Kyle Lowry. Boy, Grant, the story of your NBA career, overcoming that devastating ankle injury, I think that was in year 6. Now, you tried to play through it at first. Hindsight 2020 now. Do you approach it any differently?
No question, BA. I would have sat down and not played and probably trusted my instincts way back then. You know, certain players, when they get hurt, if they're told they're going to be out for 2 weeks, they'll try to come back in 1 week. And there's certain players, if they're told they're going to be out for 2 weeks, they'll come back in 4 weeks. I was the former. And so I needed someone to protect me from myself at times. Thankfully, in today's game, they're much more cautious and big picture oriented. And so when players get hurt, they're thinking long term as opposed to getting them back out there for that next game like they did 20 years ago.
Lowry against Simmons. Pass to Harris. On the wing, Curry. Here's Embiid. And the 76ers tack on two more.
They just look so overwhelmed inside. You know, that's why they continue to get attacked.
Yeah, I think they've got to ramp up the aggressiveness. If they don't, things are just going to get worse from here.
Lowry. It's good. And he drew contact on the shot, so he will go to the line. A three-point play opportunity. Well, throughout his career, Kyle Lowry has been fantastic on defense, as tenacious as a defender as they come, Grant.
B.A., one of my favorite players in the league. I mean, of course, Lowry's small, but has a low center of gravity. Bigger guards can't move him, and he can stay with all the smaller guards, too. Lowry's elite when it comes to taking charges.
That free throw good from Lowry. Just a little over 90 seconds gone in the third quarter. Simmons, the pass to Green. Now here's Embiid, checked by Baines. Outside for Green. Down to 5 on the shot clock. Here's Simmons. Oh, Siakam with the block.
And the coaching staff, they love this. I mean, Siakam, he's engaged, aggressive, just getting after it on the defensive end. And you just can't afford to give up that kind of look very often.
Outside Simmons. Pass to Embiid. Over Baines. Embiid can't hit. For Toronto, they've got 2 of 3 from the floor in this third quarter. Siakam outside. Going inside. And Siakam with the slam.
He's just such a long and powerful player. I mean, once Siakam gets inside like this, he's ready to jam.
Simmons, the pass to Green. Pass to Embiid. And that comes off the assist by Green. Embiid's gotten 4 this quarter.
You know, we've gotten used to seeing this from Joel Embiid, a lethal offensive player who can get hot fast.
And here's Lowry. He's got 11. Here's Siakam. And it's Toronto with another. Third quarter of basketball here. A little under 3.5 minutes gone by. All right, let's check in with Ali LaForce.
The league resumed this season with a reduction in revenue, approximately 40% of which usually comes from gate revenues and attendance. That's required compromises from all of the stakeholders. And as eager as everyone is for the return to normality, it's a process and a painful one for the league's pocketbook.
Yeah, that's right. Good point, Ali. Thank you. Curry, no good.
That's the shot they wanted. It just didn't fall.
You know what? That's a confidence shaker for him, though. I mean, that's a shot he expects to make every time.
The rebounding numbers make it obvious why they're in front.
And you know what? That tells the story in a lot of games, guys. And here you go. It's telling the story tonight, too.
Green, the pass to Embiid. Back to Green. Pass to Simmons. takes it inside. Offensive rebound. Outside for Green. Back to Embiid. Goes back up. And he takes it up and lays it in. Embiid's got 21 points in the game.
Boy, proving to be a handful once again, guys. Embiid, so tough to keep off the glass because of his agility and size.
Siakam finds Lowry. Hauled in by Curry.
They've shown the power inside. Their rebounding effort has been sensational.
Guys, that's putting it mildly. I mean, they've been absolutely dominant.
No good on the triple.
And he almost made them regret defending him so loosely.
Ananobi against Embiid. And it's blocked by Embiid. And so it looks like the Raptors will retain possession here. How about that strong defensive performance for this half's mobile one block?
You know, it appears they're determined to add to the lead, not with more offense, but with big-time D.
And the Raptors making a change here. Boucher's checked in. Siakam outside. Six on the shot clock. Fires the three. And Milton pulls it down.
Just enough of a shot contest to bother him.
Embiid from outside. Another shot. And it's Curry laying it in. Give him 20.
Hey, I like and respect the hustle of Curry that time. Doing some work on the offensive glass.
Launches a three. And Ananobi gets a three.
Could have been much better defense. I mean, you can't give this guy any room to operate.
Lowry against Curry. Harris outside. Inside. Here's Embiid. And the shot is good. Harris making the play. Harris has got his third assist of the night.
Their interior D continues to look shaky. Not a good matchup for them right now.
I'd agree with you, and I don't think they expected this one to be a game where they would get battered inside like they have.
Their defense has to do a better job of smothering those shooters.
Harris on the wing. Back to Milton. To the wing, right side. Three-pointer, Embiid. Embiid missing again.
After hitting one three in the first half, he's been unable to dial in from deep since then.
Now here's Lowry, tightly guarded.
It's huge whenever Seth Curry comes up with the block. I think it ignites the entire team.
Shooting two.
That free throw good from Lowry. So it's both teams making substitutions here. Both free throws good from Lowry. Here's Maxey. He has six. Over to the left wing. Shoots a fadeaway. And the shot is good. Dropping in off the front of the rim. Embiid's got 10 points here in the second half. Toronto's gotten 2 of 4 threes to fall here in this third quarter. Here's Thomas. Boy, he's been patient so far. Nothing yet on the scoreboard.
And the evolution of Siakam continues. Seeing him make great passes like this proves he's only getting better. Woo, scary thought.
Embiid against Siakam. Let's the three fly. A nice shot by Milton. Milton's got his second bucket of the night.
You know, one thing you got to love about Embiid is how unselfish he is. I mean, he's pretty good at spotting open teammates.
Pass to Boucher. to the middle. Out to Powell. And here's Lowry. Uneasy, too, on the layup. Lowry's got 18 points in the game.
Yeah, he's owning them on the offensive end, but, you know, he can't do it by himself.
Howard up top. Here's Korkmaz. Powell covers. And he goes strong with the one-handed jam.
Oh, man, exploding to the rim.
Yep, makes the simple play.
Yeah, he still made it look good, though.
Well, a breakthrough season for Norman Powell in 2020. Just about doubled his scoring average. And Grant, he did it with elite efficiency.
NBA Powell has shown time and time again that he can light it up. He is great from anywhere on the floor. When he gets going, he can take over a game. Sometimes with that much of a height advantage, resistance is futile.
1:10 left in the third quarter. Pass to Howard. Second chance effort, and it's good on the lay-in. Give him 8.
Sensational at hitting the glass. Howard has fantastic timing when he goes after those rebounds.
And he was fouled while in the act of shooting, so he'll take 2 free throws.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
He's off on the first. And the 76ers making a change here. He's good on the second. There's 48 seconds left to play in the third quarter of basketball. Pass to Milton. The floater. Oh, good D by Boucher. Toronto's gotten 2 of 4 threes to fall here in this third quarter. Here's Lowry. Down low. Deflected, and he recovers it. 5 to shoot. Powell outside. Philadelphia grabs the miss.
And their physical dominance has been on display. A 10-rebound advantage is a good indicator of how this game has gone.
Here's Korkmaz. And 3 quarters of play in the books. This one's all but over already. The Sixers on top, running away with it. After a quick break, we're coming right back with the start of the fourth quarter. And a worthy candidate tonight as we take a look at our State Farm assist of the game.
You can count on him to deliver a few assists like this one each and every night.
It sure is. I mean, he's a maestro. Great vision, terrific IQ, everything you want in a point guard.
And 1 quarter to go in a game that, to this point, has not been an evenly fought contest. We've got Ben Simmons, Tobias Harris out there with Danny Green. Then it's Matisse Thybulle, and it's Scott in at the pivot spot, manning the middle. That's the group on the floor for Philadelphia. To the inside, and finished off by Boucher.
B.A., when he gets the rim in his sights, it's tough to stop.
So aggressive, and a determined finisher. Nice.
And guys, I like the fact that he chose the one-hand tomahawk slam, because you get a little higher when you go off one hand and one foot.
Now here's Thybulle with the drive. Van Vliet with it. Pass to Boucher. And the foul on Ben Simmons. That's his first foul. Curry, he's checked in for Thybulle. Here's Thomas. Back to Van Vliet. Nifty move. It doesn't go for him. Good D by Simmons. It's an even three-on-three break. Green for three. And it's Boucher with the rebound. Boucher's got five rebounds tonight. Over to the wing. Here's Van Vliet. And it's good. Fought through contact. Hit the shot. And will go to the line. Baines has checked in for Powell.
One shot.
And they've been moving the ball really well tonight.
Good things come to those who take good shots.
Right side, Simmons. Got it. And the 76ers lead by 17.
Outstanding focus that time by Simmons. Nothing really rattles this guy. He's unflappable, even when he's getting bodied by the defense like that.
Thomas, that's good.
Their offense sort of clawing back to respectability. Let's see if they can keep building on this.
And we're about 2 minutes into the fourth here. And the call will be against Fred Van Vliet. That'll be a second foul of the game.
That was a good call. The defense wasn't established.
Yeah, it looked like it. I mean, he kind of slid underneath as he got to the spot, too.
Joel Embiid, he's checked in for the Sixers. Outside Curry. Got a piece of it. Here's Anunoby. Three-pointer, no good.
Man, that's his shot. Maybe he was too wide open.
Green, the pass to Simmons. Back to Green. Pass to Embiid. Ooh, poked away. Simmons for three. Three on the clock. And it's Boucher with the rebound. The Raptors have gone 3 of 5 since this fourth quarter started. Van Vliet against Green. And he converts the layup.
And now almost all their points coming from the paint.
The 76ers have gotten only 1 of 5 to fall here in the fourth. Simmons finds Embiid. Harris outside. Pass to Embiid. Out to Harris. Screen by Embiid. Harris drives in. And that one, good. Harris has got his first bucket of the night.
You know, we talk a lot about athleticism, guys. It's important. And right there, Harris used his well to create for himself.
Here's Van Vliet. Takes a three. And Baines with the three.
After a poor offensive first half, some nice adjustments made by this staff, and their shooting percentage is climbing.
We played just over 3.5 minutes now in the fourth quarter. Out to Harris. Takes the three. No luck on that one. So the Raptors will take it the other way.
And, you know, even though they're on top, they're winning. I mean, they could use more from him. Trying to shut the door on this one.
Outside Simmons. And the bucket counts. And he is on his way to the line. He'll try to make it a three-point play. Lowry, he's checked in for Toronto.
You know, you look at Ben Simmons, and the thing that jumps out to me is his all-around game. I mean, it's absolutely terrific. He's a stat sheet stuffer, supreme.
Pass to Lowry. Launches it. And it's Philadelphia with the rebound. Embiid's got 6 rebounds in the game. Inside. And Embiid with the slam.
Boy, this big guy, Joel Embiid, is a center with an awesome dunking arsenal.
Simmons against Van Vliet.
Good offense beats good defense? Not always.
Pass to Embiid. It's blocked. And that's out of bounds. Philadelphia will retain possession. And the Raptors making a change here. Siakam's checked in. Toronto on D. It's a 16-point game. Pass to Harris. Embiid with it. Just 5 to shoot. Left side, Green. Here's the 3. They get it back. Harris's shot is good. Harris has gotten 4 this quarter.
Outstanding work by Harris to get his hands dirty on that offensive glass.
Now Siakam. He takes it in. And he's going to the line for 2. The official saw contact while he was going up. That one on Harris.
Take a break. Take a break. 2 shots.
First one falls for him. And he can't hit the second.
Yeah, you know, nobody really considers Tobias Harris as an elite defender, but by all accounts, he's an above-average one. Opposing teams know that he's one of the best defenders on their team.
Toronto has gone 2 of 4 from the perimeter here in the fourth quarter. Lowry against Simmons. Philadelphia's got nothing to fall from outside the arc here in the fourth. 0 for 4. That is now his 7th field goal in 10 attempts. Impressive. And grant a 6'11 wingspan for Tobias Harris. That's a big bonus for him on defense.
It really is. I mean, and you combine that with Harris's lateral quickness, and you can see the effect he has. Most people gloss over his defense with the eye test, but all the numbers say that he's very much a positive on that end of the floor.
To the paint. Harris. And Harris throws it down.
They've been very well-rounded and extremely focused.
Almost no holes in their performance tonight. They've been tremendous.
Here's the floater. Lowry with the bucket, getting it done inside. Lowry's got 20 points.
Such a graceful move, showing off the floater game.
And here is Green. Pass to Embiid. Out to Harris. Now here's Simmons. Shot clock at 6. Into the lane. And slam dunk by Simmons.
The slashability of Simmons. Really creating havoc for the defense with his aggressive cutting mentality.
Timeout called. The Raptors. Grant, I know you faced Kobe Bryant a lot over the years. What's the main thing you'll remember about him?
Well, B.A., there's so much to remember about the late, great Kobe Bryant. The buzzer beaters, the excellence, the dedication and focus he brought to his entire career. The thing that's beautiful about Kobe's journey was him starting off as a young man, trying to find his way, at times struggling, endearing himself to his teammates. And as he went through his career, He really became the elder statesman, the big brother. His influence on today's players was just incredible. And I think it was just a beautiful story to follow from start to finish. What an incredible ambassador for the game. What an incredible leader in the game of basketball. And he's someone that we all sorely miss today.
All right, time now to present our New Balance Player of the Game, Ben Simmons.
Hey, guess what? This was his game all night. I mean, he tore through the defense and almost never took a bad shot out there. Really, a level of offensive consistency most players can only dream of.
You know, I got to applaud his incredible energy out there tonight. Losing again was not an option for him. He wouldn't settle for anything other than a win. Now here's Lowry. Van Vliet outside. Outside Ananobi. Well, Grant, you played when teams didn't have a sophisticated method of managing players' minutes. I want to hear the Grant Hill thoughts on load management.
Well, I'll tell you what, BA, load management is the new wave in the NBA, and that is so valuable and important to a team. You factor in 82 games, travel, getting in late at night on the road, guys working out year-round. It's so important to think big picture as players go throughout their career. So load management, the sophistication that's applied now is so important and critical. And I'm a little jealous. I wish they had that back when I played.
Having players available in crunch time and extending careers. Siakam hits them both. Simmons with it. Have to love his hustle tonight.
Yeah, B.A., just one more rebound and he'll have a double-double.
Curry against Van Vliet. And the basket by Curry. Curry's got 22 points.
Boy, Curry knows that kind of physical finish can give his team a spark.
1:57 left in the fourth quarter. Pass to Boucher. Out to the right wing. Just 5 on the clock. Here's Siakam. And Embiid with the block. Lowry against Simmons. Harris outside. Here's Embiid. That falls. Nice setup by Harris. Harris has got assist number 5 here tonight. The Raptors have gone just 6 of 14 in this final quarter.
And you can see how scary this team can be when everything is clicking for them. Just a terrific performance for the 76ers.
It's impressive how the reserve players stepped up and delivered in this one.
They didn't just help out. They made a big impact and really secured the win for their team.
Simmons against Lowry. Pass to Curry. Back to Simmons. Outside, Green. Harris on the wing. He's covered by Siakam. Here's Embiid. Out to Harris. Harris is doubled. Green for 3. No good there. And Toronto will come the other way. Here's Siakam. We've got 33 seconds left to play in the fourth quarter of this one. Pass to Lowry. Oh. fires from 14. No good. In and out off the rim. Here's Philadelphia. They're on a 19-7 run. Now here's Simmons, covered by Boucher. Now Simmons. So it's the 76ers winning this one easily. Boy, they were something special to watch tonight, and the crowd loving every second of it.
It's always a great feeling when you play this well for your fans. This team really showed what it's capable of.
All right, now let's check in with Allie LaForce. Allie, what do you have?
Joel, in the past, you've certainly had your critics, and you have not run from them. What are you looking to prove out there?
Just being dominant, so I want every time people hear my name, I want them to know that I'm a dominant player.
Well, you do have the ability to dominate every single night. Good luck moving forward.
Thanks, Allie. Great interview once again. And that's going to do it tonight, folks, for our broadcast. For Grant Hill, Clark Kellogg, and Allie LaForce, this is Brian Anderson thanking you for watching. So long, everybody.